A message to single mothers. I was watching a Coach Red Pill video, and he's talking about why single mothers can't raise men, right? Why they really can't raise men effectively by themselves, and how men and women are very different when it comes to raising kids, right? And how men push the child to go out into the world and take care of business, and how women like to coddle the child and protect it from the world. So I thought I would give you guys my story as a child, as a man from a single mother. And basically, the only way a single mom can effectively raise at least a son, right? 'Cause my mom just had a son, can raise a son to go out into the world and take care of his business, right? The only way a single mother can raise a son to go out into the world. So, the difference between my mom and most single mothers is my mom was incredibly tough on me. She wasn't, feminine and girly and coddling me and anything like that. My mom, it was, she's from Lebanon, she's Lebanese, born and raised there. And even though I grew up in America, I was raised like old school Lebanese. So she's very tough. She was very unforgiving, pushing me to go out there and take care of business, pushing me to go out and learn how to fight, pushing me to go out and get jobs and all kinds of stuff like that. And that's really one of the main problems, with single moms, at least in America, is they grew up so soft and sheltered and coddled here. They raise these soft, coddled sons, and the world is not nearly as forgiving towards men as it is towards women. So a lot of these women raising these sons, at least, you're not doing him any justice by coddling him, because no one else is gonna coddle him when he's out in the world. You actually need to be tough on him, and it's kind of sad and it's kind of dysfunctional. And even what my mom did was kind of dysfunctional to a degree, but she knew she had to do what she had to do. You kind of have to play the role of the father more than the mother. You have to just be, harder than you usually would on the kid, because he's already at a huge disadvantage compared to other kids. And I was already at a huge disadvantage too. But and I'm not gonna lie, I think, maybe my mom might have overdid it a little bit, and I might have become a little too extreme and a little too aggressive. But it's a hell of a lot better than being too much on the other side. You understand what I'm saying? It's still way better than being too much on the soft, submissive side, which most men raised by single mothers are on. I have a hard time relating to men in today's society, because a lot of them are just so soft and bitch made. I just stomp all over them. I take their jobs, I take their women. I take so much from most men I encounter because they are so soft. Every now and then I'll meet a tough one that had like a dad, and we'll have a mutual respect and we'll go our separate ways. But most men are so soft because, women, for the most part, they only know how to coddle and protect their kids, but they don't know how to prepare them for the world. So if you're a single mother listening to this video, you have to play the part of the father more than the mother, because the role of the father is going to prepare your kid, at least your son, for success and overall happiness in the real world, much more than just playing the feminine part of coddling and spoiling your kid. I see so many single moms do that, and I'm like, your kid is gonna get fucking wrecked when they go out into society. I mean, they're gonna get like fucking body slammed, metaphorically speaking, because there are men like me with like a predator mentality that are gonna take what they want from the world. And when we encounter your soft sons, we're not gonna have any mercy towards them. So you need to have that same understanding when you're raising your sons. That you need to be as tough on them as possible. And even a mother at her toughest is nowhere near as tough as a father is. at his toughest. So this isn't a video where I'm gonna bash single moms talking about how you made a mistake and how 80% of boys in jail are because of single moms. We already know all that shit. This is really just a message to single moms that if you want your son to have a fighting chance, you need to toughen them up and be hard on them and not be so coddly and emotionally, caught up in feelings. Because the world isn't going to give a fuck about your son's feelings, or your son's emotions, or your son's disadvantage. It's a very cold, predatory world out there, and everyone is trying to destroy everyone and take what they have at all turns and all twists and in every aspect of life. So you're not doing your son any favors being soft and sensitive, and I know it goes against your nature as a woman to do that. But you already created a dysfunctional situation for yourself by being a single parent. So now you have to sort of take a dysfunctional approach to solve a dysfunctional problem. And that is playing a tougher, less forgiving role. And I'm sure it's going to kill you inside a little bit. And I'm sure it might have killed my mom inside a little bit to be as tough as she was on me. But it worked out in the end so much better. And don't get it twisted. I mean, your son is still going to suffer tremendously without having a father in those growing years. And you're still going to suffer to a degree, having to be tougher on him than you would have liked to. But it's going to pay off in the end way more. And it's going to lead to overall happiness that your son would not have otherwise. Not, there's nothing worse than, sending a boy out into the world, unprepared and soft and sensitive and weak, only to just get eaten alive by the system and by other men and even by women who prey on him as a soft sucker that they can use to, get pregnant and have kids and put them on child support. To the mothers listening, you gotta understand, by being soft on your son, not only are you making him a victim to other men, but you're making him a victim to women as well. Because women prey on soft, sensitive, weak, confused men to trick them into becoming their beta male provider and putting them on child support and then cheating on them with more of an asshole kind of guy. So you're opening your son up to all kinds of predatory behavior from both genders when you are soft and easy on them. Now, I'm not qualified to speak on how a single mother would raise a daughter, because I was a son in a single mother situation, so I'm not even gonna go there. I guess this is more for the single mothers with sons, how to effectively raise them in the society. But that's really just the moral of the story. That's what my mom did. That's what was effective for her. When I was a kid, a lot of my friends came from single mother households, but I noticed how all my friends' moms were super soft and easy and weak on them, and they turned out to be like little bitches when they grew up. But my mom had this tough, old school Middle Eastern, mentality. And maybe a lot of that is because she grew up in a third world country. She would tell me stories how when she was a kid, the tanks would chase her to school, like the military tank would chase her to school, and she would get in car accidents because snipers would be shooting at other cars on the road and it would kill someone, and then she'd get in a car accident, all kinds of crazy shit, growing up on a third world country. But that made her tough and able to handle the world, and that made her tough enough to raise me to be tough, even without a father. Now, was my childhood anywhere near what it should have been? No. Am I anywhere near as satisfied as I would have been if I had both parents? No. But it was just enough to get me out into the world without being a complete fuck up, and totally being weak and spineless to not handle my business. I'm nowhere near what I should be as a man, and your son is never gonna be what he should be as a man because you raised him without a father. But at least if you're tough enough on him, he will be able to survive and thrive in this world and still get, 60 to 70% of what he wants out of life. Versus if you're soft and coddling on him and he just goes out there and gets, destroyed. So that's really just a message to single mothers.